Today we are going to discuss about three different concepts. One is dihybrid test cross, second one is dihybrid back cross, and third one is trihybrid cross. Before we are going to discuss about those aspects, now let us recall the important points regarding the last class, that is dihybrid cross. What is a dihybrid cross? When a cross is made between two plants differing in two characters or two pairs of contrasting traits is called dihybrid cross. What are the parents that you have selected? The pure parents, the pure plants are true breeding or pure breeding lines, yellow round and green wrinkled. When yellow round seeded plants, pure breeding yellow round seeded plants are crossed with pure breeding wrinkled, green wrinkled plants. In the F1, phenotypically, all yellow round were obtained, but genotypically, double heterozygous individuals are obtained. That means phenotypically they resemble the dominant parent, but genotypically they differ. When F1 are selfed, F2 plants are obtained. In the F2, what is the phenotypic ratio? 9:3:3:1. How many types of phenotypes were obtained? 4 types. What are the 4 types? Yellow round, yellow wrinkled, green round, green wrinkled. Out of the 4 types, how many resemble the parents? 2 types, yellow round, green wrinkled. The remaining 2 are given one name. What are they? Recombinations. Recombinations are new combinations. These are popularly called as Mendelian recombinations. What is the ratio between parental combinations and recombinations? Parental combination 9+1, recombinations 3+3, that is 10:5, that is equal to 5:3. In the F2, how many types of genotypes are obtained? 9 types. Genotypes are obtained in which ratio? 1:2:2:2:4:1:2:2:1:2:2:1. 9 types of genotypes are obtained. What is the ratio between number of types of phenotypes and number of types of genotypes? Phenotypes are 4, genotypes are 9. 4:9. Right? Like that, we have seen the dihybrid cross in the last class. Based on the results of dihybrid cross, Mendel proposed law of independent assortment. What is meant by law of independent assortment? When two pairs of alleles combined in a hybrid, one pair of traits of a character segregate independently from next pair of traits of character. This is called as law of independent assortment. Law of independent assortment is applicable from dihybrid cross only because it requires minimum 2 pairs of traits. It is not applicable to monohybrid cross. It is applicable to dihybrid, trihybrid, tetrahybrid, etc. Up to this, in the last class, we are completed. And now we go with the first one, that is dihybrid test cross. Dihybrid test cross. What is a test cross? For what purpose test cross is conducted? Already we know. Test cross is conducted to determine the genotype of the dominant phenotype. Phenotype is known, but genotype is not known. In order to determine the genotype, test cross is conducted. Then what is meant by test cross? Cross between an individual with unknown phenotype but known phenotype with double recessive parent is called as dihybrid test cross. I repeat here, what is meant by dihybrid test cross? Cross between an individual having unknown genotype with two dominant phenotypic characters with a double recessive parent is called as dihybrid test cross. That is, the phenotype is yellow round. Crossed with double recessive parent, that is green wrinkled. The genotype, that this is double recessive parent. Okay, now what is the genotype of this one? The F1 dihybrid, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. What is the genotype? Small y, small r. Now, this can form how many types of gametes? 4 types of gametes. The 4 types of gametes are capital Y, capital R, capital Y, small r, small y, capital R, small y, small r. This can form only one type, that is small y, small r, because it is homozygous, it is heterozygous for both the characters. For yellow, heterozygous, for round, heterozygous. Therefore, 4 types of gametes are formed. Here, for both the characters, it is homozygous. Now, think that these are X, this is male gamete. When these are fused, the progeny, test cross progeny are obtained. Let us see. Capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. Then, capital Y, small r, small r. Then, small y, capital R, small r. Then, small y, small r, small r. These are the genotypes. These are the genotypes. Let us write the phenotypes for these genotypes. See, yellow round, yellow wrinkled, green round, green wrinkled. This is yellow round. This is green ring, yellow wrinkled. This is green round. This is green wrinkled. Now let us see number of types of phenotypes in test cross produced. Number of types of phenotypes produced in test cross is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 are different. 4 are obtained in equal ratio. 4 types of phenotypes are produced. Similarly, see the number of genotypes. This is different. So, 4 types of genotypes are obtained in equal ratio. Therefore, here also, number of types of genotypes is equal to 4. In the dihybrid test cross, number of types of phenotypes produced 4. Number of types of genotypes produced 4. Therefore, ratio between number of types of phenotypes and genotypes is equal to 4:4, that is equal to 1:1, right? So I will repeat again. Test cross results, dihybrid test cross. In the dihybrid test cross, totally how many types of phenotypes are produced? 4 types. Yellow round, yellow wrinkled, green round, green wrinkled. How many types of genotypes are produced? 4 types. Capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. Capital Y, small r, small r. Small y, capital R, small r. Small y, small r, small r. Therefore, the ratio between number of types of phenotypes and number of types of genotypes is 1:1. Similarly, dihybrid test cross phenotypic ratio is 1:1:1. See, yellow round 1, yellow wrinkled 1, green round 1, green wrinkled 1. Dihybrid test cross phenotypic ratio is 1:1. Similarly, genotypic ratio, dihybrid test cross genotypic ratio is this one, one type, this one, one, this one, so one type, this one also one type. Therefore, the genotype dihybrid test cross genotypic ratio 1:1:1:1. That means dihybrid test cross phenotypic ratio, dihybrid test cross genotypic ratio was found to be the same, that is 1:1:1:1. I think you got it. So this is about test cross. I repeat briefly. Cross between an individual having a known dominant phenotype and unknown genotype with a double recessive parent is called dihybrid test cross. It differs in two characters or two pairs of traits. For example, when F2 yellow round is crossed with green wrinkled, that is double recessive parent, it produces genotypically 4 types and phenotypically 4 types. That means this parent can form 4 types of gametes. This parent can form 1 type of gametes because it is heterozygous for both the characters. It is homozygous for both the characters. Hence, it can form 4 types. It can form only 1 type. Finally, 4 types of genotypes, 4 types of phenotypes are obtained in the ratio of 1:1. And the dihybrid test cross phenotypic ratio 1:1:1:1. Similarly, the dihybrid test cross genotypic ratio is also same, that is 1:1:1. Therefore, dihybrid test cross phenotypic ratio, dihybrid test cross genotypic ratio, both are found to be the same. That is 1:1:1:1. That's all. The next one is dihybrid back cross. Dihybrid back cross. Next one, dihybrid back cross. Cross between F1 hybrid with either of the parents. Cross between F1 with either of the parents is called back cross. As they differ in two characters, it is called dihybrid back cross. As it differ in two characters, it is called dihybrid back cross. Already we are crossed with recessive parent under test cross. That is why I told you test cross is a type of back cross. So the remaining one, that means F1 is crossed with the dominant parent Such back cross is called out cross. The back cross in which when F1 is crossed with the dominant parent is called as out cross. Let us see that cross. Crossing of F1 hybrid with dominant parent for both the traits. Here it is yellow round. For example, I am taking yellow round. Here also yellow round. That is phenotypically F1 phenotype, dominant parent phenotype for both the traits is same. But genotypically, this is heterozygous and this is homozygous. Okay? This is homozygous. So this is called outcross. Outcross is a backcross. Okay? Right now, it can form four types of gametes. It can form one type of gametes as usual. As it is heterozygous, it can form four types. Capital Y, capital R. Capital Y, small r. Small y, capital R. Small y, small r. Similarly, it can form capital Y, capital R. Okay? So as it is heterozygous for both the characters, it can form four types. For both the characters, it is homozygous. It can form only one type. Now you cross. We will get capital Y, capital Y, capital R, capital R. Similarly, capital Y, capital Y, capital R, small r. Similarly, capital Y, small y, capital R, capital R. Similarly, capital Y, capital R, small r. These are the genotypes. So, look at the genotypes. Four genotypes are different. Therefore, genotypic ratio of dihybrid test cross is 1:1:1:1. Okay? Genotypic ratio of dihybrid back cross 1:1:1:1 because four types of genotypes are different. Capital Y, capital Y, capital R, one type. Capital Y, capital R, small r, another type. Capital Y, small y, capital R, another type. Capital Y, capital R, small r, another type. So, four types of genotypes are obtained in the ratio of 1:1. Therefore, dihybrid back cross genotypic ratio is 1:1:1. Now, let us see the phenotypes for these genotypes. This is yellow round. This is yellow round. This is also yellow round. This is also yellow round. Yellow round. See, number of types of genotypes. Four types. Number of types of phenotypes. Only one type. See, all are yellow round. Yellow round, yellow round, yellow round, yellow round. Only one parent characters are phenotypically are obtained. But genotypes are different. So phenotypes are 100% one type. Phenotypes are 100% one type, that is yellow round. But genotypically, four different types of genotypes are obtained. This is about dihybrid test cross. I repeat again, you go through that. Dihybrid test cross. Cross between F1 hybrid with a double dominant parent is called dihybrid back cross. For example, F1 yellow round is crossed with yellow round dominant parent. F1 hybrid can form four types of gametes, whereas the dominant parent can form one type of gamete. When these gametes think that these are eggs, this is a pollen grain, you will get four different types of genotypes in the ratio of 1:1:1:1, and the phenotypes are found to be the same. They are yellow round. That means genotypes are four, phenotypes are one type. Four types of genotypes, four types are obtained. And the genotypic ratio is 1:1:1:1, but phenotypical ratio we don't obtain. All are one types. Therefore, they all are 100% are one type. This is true, similar to that of dihybrid, monohybrid test cross and monohybrid back cross. Okay, this is about the second important phenomena. And now we go for the very important one, another one, that is trihybrid cross. Trihybrid cross. What is meant by trihybrid cross? Cross between two plants differing in three characters or three pairs of contrasting traits is known as trihybrid cross. What is trihybrid cross? When a cross is made between two plants differing in three characters or three pairs of contrasting traits is known as trihybrid cross. Right? That means in trihybrid cross, how many characters you have to consider? Three characters. That means how many contrasting traits? Three contrasting traits. Let us see, I'm taking three characters here. The three characters are one, seed color, I am taking. Second one, seed shape. Third one, flower color. Flower color. These are the three characters: seed color, seed shape, flower color. Now, what are the traits for seed color? Yellow, green. What are the traits for shape? Round, wrinkled. Similarly, what are the traits for flower color? Violet, white. Yellow is dominant over green. Round is dominant over wrinkled. Violet is dominant over white. Right? Seed color, seed shape, flower color. Seed colors are yellow, green. Seed shapes are round, wrinkled. Flower colors are violet and white. Yellow is dominant over green. Round is dominant over wrinkled. Violet is dominant over white. Okay. Now, what kind of parents must be selected? True breeding lines or pure breeding lines must be selected. Therefore, the parents are, we represent parents. The parents are yellow, round, violet, and green, wrinkled, white. These are the pure parents. Now, what are the genotypes of these parents? Capital Y, capital Y, capital R, capital R, capital V, capital V. These are small y, small y, small r, small r, small v, small v. These are the genotypes of their parents. Now, what kinds of gametes are produced? Whatever may be the length of the genotype, if they are all are homozygous, they produce one type of gamete only. Let us see. From this one allele, from this one allele, from this one allele. Therefore, the gamete is capital Y, capital R, capital V. The number may be many, but type is only one type. Similarly, here also, from this one, so that small y, small r, small v. Okay, when you cross these two, it produces F1 plants. The F1 plants are capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital V, small v. These are yellow, round, and violet. Yellow, round, violet. So when a pure breeding yellow, round, violet flowers containing plant is crossed with pure breeding green, wrinkled white flowers containing plant, in the F1, all yellow, round, violet plants are obtained. That means phenotypically, these F1 plants resembling one of the parent, that is the dominant parent, but genotypically different. Triheterozygous individuals are obtained genotypically. Triheterozygous, 1, 2, 3, trihybrids, one hybrid, second hybrid, third hybrid, that trihybrids are produced. These are triheterozygous genotypically, but phenotypically they resemble to that of one of the dominant parent. Now, in order to produce F2 plants, they must be selfed. Selfing of F1 produces F2. F1, yellow, round, violet into F1, yellow, round, violet. F1, yellow, round, violet into F1, yellow, round, violet. Right, now the genotypes are capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital V, small v. Similarly, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital V, small v. These are the genotypes. And you know very well that by using a simple formula, that is 2 power n, we can calculate the number of types of gametes produced by a genotype by considering the number of heterozygous pairs of alleles. For example, this one, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital V, small v. How many types of gametes it can produce? How can it determine? 2 power n, where n is equal to number of pairs of heterozygous alleles. 1, 2, 3. How many pairs of heterozygous alleles are there? 3 pairs. That is equal to n is equal to 3. Therefore, 2 power 3. That is equal to 2 into 2 into 2. That is equal to 8. That means it can produce 8 types of gametes. Think that these are eggs. This is also the same type of genotype. Therefore, it also can produce 8 types of gametes. So this can form 8 types of eggs. This can form 8 types of pollen grains. So in order to determine the number of types of gametes produced by a plant having a particular genotype is used by using a formula called, calculated by using a formula called 2 power n. Here n is the number of heterozygous pairs of alleles. The number of heterozygous pairs of alleles here is 1, 2, 3. Therefore, 2 power 3, 2 into 2 into 2, that is equal to 8. Therefore, it can form 8 type and it can also form 8 type. Then what are those 8 types? Let us see. I told you yesterday, for example, the number of types of genotypes formed can be demonstrated by using Fourcoline method. Here, for example, I am taking capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital V, small v, right? From that, how many it can produce? Let us see. By using fork line method, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital R, small r. Similarly, capital V, small v, capital V, small v, capital V, small v, capital V, small v. Now from this, see the types of gametes formed. It can form capital Y, capital R, capital V. Then capital Y, capital R, small v. Similarly, capital Y, small r, capital V. Capital Y, small r, capital V. Then capital Y, small r, small v. Then small y, capital R, capital V. Small y, capital R, small v. Small y, small r, capital V. Small y, small r, small v. See that? So a plant having, for example, this genotype produce these 8 types of gametes. How many these are? 8 types. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How many types it can produce? We can use this formula. What are they? In order to see that, you have to use fork line method. So that means this individual can form 8 types of gametes, this type, and this also can form. That means the male also produce same type of gametes. Right? Now, in order to get F2 generation plants, these 8 must crossed with these 8, so that 8 into 8, 64 zygotes are obtained. These 8 must combine with these 8, totally 8 into 8, 64 zygotes are obtained. How many are obtained totally? 64. That means for trihybrid cross, in order to produce F2 plant, a Punnett square or checkerboard having 64 square boxes must be drawn. But it is very difficult and it is time consuming. Therefore, we discuss the important points from that table. Okay, right. I think you understand regarding trihybrid cross. Once again, before you are going to discuss about the F2, let us once again explain briefly regarding trihybrid cross. Cross between two plants differing in 3 characters or 3 pairs of traits is called trihybrid cross. For example, a pure breeding yellow round violet flower containing plant is crossed with a pure breeding green wrinkled white flower containing plant in the F1. In the F1, all phenotypically one type yellow round violet are obtained. When these, but genotypically different. When F1 are selfed, in the F2, 64 zygotes are produced. 64 zygotes are produced by combining with 8 types of male gametes and 8 types of female gametes. Totally 64 are obtained. So from this type, let us see how many phenotypes obtained, how many genotypes obtained, and what is the phenotypic ratio. Okay, in trihybrid cross, the number of types of phenotypes produced 8. While reading this one, you should recollect number of types of phenotypes in monohybrid 2, number of types of phenotypes in dihybrid 4. Similarly, number of types of phenotypes in trihybrid 8. So number of types of phenotypes formed in trihybrid cross, 8. Similarly, number of types of genotypes formed in trihybrid cross is equal to 27. Out of 64 zygotes in 64 boxes are there, genotypes. How many types of genotypes are among 64? Only 27. Out of 64, how many phenotypes are there? Only 8. Therefore, ratio between number of types of phenotypes and genotypes is equal to 8:27. Very important. Ratio between number of types of phenotypes and genotypes is 8:27. Okay, right. Now, the trihybrid phenotypic ratio, I told you types are 8 types. Those 8 out of 64 are produced in what ratio? That what I am telling now. What is the trihybrid phenotypic ratio? 27:9:9:9:3:3:3:1. Okay, this is the very important one. Trihybrid phenotypic ratio 27:9:9:3:3:3:1. This is the ratio. Number of types of phenotypes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Number of types is 8. The ratio is this one. You should remember. But it is very difficult to write the genotypic ratio. Generally, the questions won't ask based on genotypic ratio. Just you remember, phenotypic ratio is enough. And in order to know, I told you that how many types of genotypes are produced? 27. I will tell you simple formula. Suppose a genotype is given. From that genotype, how many crossing of that genotype can produce how many types of genotypes? The number of types of genotypes formed by a plant having genotypes. Example, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital V, small v are crossed. That means when this one is crossed with this one, how many types of genotypes are possible? It can be calculated by using a simple formula, that is 3 power n. That is 3 power n. I will tell you again. The number of types of genotypes formed by a plant having genotype. For example, capital Y small y, capital R small r, capital V small v are crossed. This one with this one is crossed. How many is possible? 27 genotypes are obtained. 27 genotypes are obtained from this. Right? I think you understand this. In trihybrid cross, the number of types of phenotypes formed, 8. The number of types of genotypes obtained, 27. Out of 64. Phenotypes out of 64, types of phenotypes, 8. Types of genotypes, 27. Ratio 8:27. Trihybrid phenotypic ratio, 27 is to 9 is to 9 is to 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1. In order to calculate the number of types of genotypes, when a cross is made between two genotypes, is 3 power n, 3 power n. For example, these genotypes, where n is the number of heterozygous, 1, 2, 3, that is equal to 3 into 3 into 3, that is equal to 27. Example for this. Right. Now, I told you that 8 types of genotypes, phenotypes are produced. But genotypes are very difficult. I told you phenotypes can be seen. Now I will tell you what are those 8 types of phenotypes. I will write here. Types of phenotypes. How many produced? 8. Types of phenotypes. The types of phenotypes are 1. For this, yellow, round, violet, 27. Second, yellow, round, white, 9. Third one, yellow, green, violet, 9. Fourth one, yellow, green, white, 9. Next, fifth one, green, round, violet, 3. Then green, round, white, 3. Next, wrinkled. Then wrinkled, violet, 3. Green, wrinkled, white, 1. I repeat again all these. In that 64 boxes containing Punnett square, totally the types of phenotypes are 8 types. What are those 8 types? Let us see. Yellow, round, violet, 27. Yellow, round, white, 9. Yellow, wrinkled, violet, 9. Yellow, wrinkled, white, 9. Green, round, violet, 3. Green, round, white, 3. Green, wrinkled, violet, 3. Green, wrinkled, white, 3. So totally see this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Total types are 8 types of phenotypes. These are the phenotypes. Totally how many types of phenotypes are obtained? 8 types. They are obtained in what ratio? 27 is to 9 is to 9 is to 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1. These are the types of phenotypes. Like that, 27 types of genotypes are obtained. I told you so many times, it is very difficult, not required also. Right. And then, trihybrid test cross. Trihybrid test cross. Trihybrid test cross means cross between an individual having known genotype and 3 dominant traits, dominant pairs of traits, with a plant having triple recessive parent. That cross is called trihybrid test cross. Trihybrid test cross ratio is 1:1:1:1:1:1:1:1:1. Trihybrid test cross ratio 1:1:1:1:1:1:1:1. Try to recollect dihybrid test cross ratio, dihybrid test cross ratio. 1:1:1:1. Try to recollect monohybrid test cross ratio. 1:1. See this. While reading trihybrid, try to recollect the monohybrid dihybrid also. Monohybrid test cross ratio 1:1. Dihybrid test cross ratio 1:1:1:1. Trihybrid test cross ratio 1:1:1:1:1:1:1:1:1. These are the test cross ratios. Similarly, while reading the phenotypic ratio, monohybrid phenotypic ratio 3:1. Dihybrid phenotypic ratio 9:3:3:1. Trihybrid phenotypic ratio 27:9:9:9:3:3:1. For genotypic ratio, monohybrid genotypic ratio 1:2:1. Dihybrid genotypic ratio 1:2:2:4:1:2:1:2:1. But trihybrid genotypic ratio is difficult. Therefore, it is not required. Okay, that means finally we conclude trihybrid cross is a combination of three monohybrid crosses. Trihybrid cross is a combination of three monohybrid cross. You can get this phenotypic ratio from monohybrid crosses. For example, trihybrid cross is a combination of three monohybrid crosses. That is equal to 3:1, one monohybrid, then 3:1, second monohybrid, then 3:1, third monohybrid. So trihybrid cross is a combination of three monohybrid crosses. When you multiply, you will get it 27:1, 9:3:3:1, and then you will get 3:1. So that you multiply 27:9:9:9:3:3:1. Right? So therefore, trihybrid cross is a combination of three monohybrid crosses. If you multiply, you will get the phenotypic ratio also. This is about trihybrid cross. Today, I completed three concepts. One is dihybrid test cross in comprehensive manner. Second one, dihybrid back cross. And third one, trihybrid cross. Their details regarding the trihybrid cross I have given. So that's all today, and continue in the next class. Thank you.